So over the past couple days, there's been a lot of discussion around Bernie Sanders and the role the mainstream media played in him not winning the Democratic nomination. And Bernie Sanders weighed in over the past couple days, suggesting that after Nevada, after his massive win in the Nevada caucus, where he built on real strength with union workers and with Latino Americans, the mainstream media, the establishment, went into overdrive to try and stop him and build an anything but Bernie Sanders coalition. And as Bernie noted, they succeeded, and that was that. And from South Carolina into Super Tuesday and after, Bernie could never regain the momentum that he lost to Joe Biden. And whether it was downplaying Bernie's strength or whether it was overinflating the significance and importance of Joe Biden's South Carolina victory, the media played a central role in the quick shift in support from Bernie Sanders to Joe Biden. And in the very quick shift of polls that showed Bernie Sanders with a massive national lead into a massive national deficit versus Joe Biden in the matter of 72 hours, maybe a little bit longer, maybe even a little bit shorter. There's no doubt in my mind that the media played that role. But if you listen to CNN and Chris Cillizza, who published an article about this, they argue that there's no evidence of a systemic anti-Bernie Sanders media bias. That is BS. We know that the media, on the whole, not every single individual source, every single individual day, but on the whole, was definitely anti-Bernie Sanders. That they were either supporting another candidate or they were cycling through every possible choice to find somebody that wasn't Bernie to be the nominee. There were lies about Bernie Sanders. There were decontextualized arguments about Bernie Sanders. We know that they would ignore Bernie Sanders when they could and highlight his mistakes and highlight shortcomings whenever possible. And when they couldn't ignore Bernie, they scaremongered about Bernie. They compared Bernie to a virus. They compared Bernie to an army marching upon France. They compared Bernie to, a hostile takeover of the Democratic Party. Those are things you heard from Joyanne Reid and from Chris Matthews and from so many others, that Bernie was this outside hostile force coming to steal the Democratic Party from those it truly belonged to the neoliberals it truly belonged to. You saw an entire week of focus, it seems, an entire week of coverage about how Bernie Sanders praised elements of Cuba's educational and healthcare systems. Even though Barack Obama did much the same thing just a few years ago, Bernie Sanders saying nice things about Cuba, again, not nice things about the entire regime, but nice things about Cuba 30 plus years ago, was made national news for days. Days and days and days and days. Not because it mattered, but because they were trying anything they could, any little thing they could, to take the nomination away from Bernie, to try to tear down the Bernie movement, to give the neoliberals a chance to attack Bernie Sanders. In all of the final debates, questions were often framed about why Bernie's ideas can't work. Explain to me how your plans are better than Bernie's. Bernie Sanders said this awful thing. What would you say to Bernie for saying it? And on and on and on and on. And those debates were almost always hosted in part by media organizations. The moderators and the people covering it in the spin rooms were people from MSNBC and CNN and other major sources, which were hostile to Bernie Sanders. On all of these issues, every single day, Bernie Sanders was getting more negative coverage than he was getting positive coverage. It was always about how Bernie Sanders is going to lose the election. And you even had people like Chris Matthews, openly suggest that it might be better the Democratic Party lose. You had people like James Carville on MSNBC every single gosh darn day saying that Bernie's gonna lose, that we need to unite against him, we need to stop him at the convention with the superdelegates if needed. And it was all about why Bernie isn't good, why Bernie is bad, how we can stop him. This isn't over yet. We can stop this dangerous socialist from capturing our beloved Democratic Party. That was the coverage. And so it's perfectly reasonable for Bernie Sanders to say that the media played a massive role. And as I touched on earlier, it's not at all an exaggeration to note that Joe Biden got dozens and dozens of millions of dollars of free advertising from these news networks when they pumped him up every single hour of every single day from the time the South Carolina results came in until the Super Tuesday polls closed, and even afterwards. And so for all these people saying, you know, Bernie Sanders had more money, he had more organization, and Joe Biden still won, well, I think what that tells me is the media played such a foundational role in Biden's recovery that it in some ways outweighed the organizational strength of Bernie Sanders. And so while you can't necessarily say that the media is the only reason Bernie Sanders didn't win, after all, some of the states weren't all that close, and I wonder even if the media was more fair and balanced, that Bernie Sanders might have still lost this primary, but not nearly by the same margins. And I think it is possible to say that the biggest reason Bernie Sanders didn't win is that mainstream media sources, which are trusted by older establishment Democratic base voters, were uniformly against Bernie almost every step of the way, and those people took their cue from MSNBC and from CNN, and they went against Bernie. And I do feel that more than any other reason, the media was the biggest factor in Bernie Sanders' defeat. If you really do think the media wasn't systemically against Bernie, and they didn't play perhaps the biggest role in how he went from a national frontrunner, a heavy frontrunner in Nevada, to less than a week later essentially being out of the primary, you're kidding yourself.